Okay, so in this topic we see refraction at spherical surfaces. That is, we see here the refraction takes place from a rarer medium to a denser medium. Imaging is not like the interface what you see in the last day. The spherical surface, that too we see that it is convex towards the rarer medium. Now, in this, we take some sign conventions and assumptions. The main assumption what we take in this case, like in the mirror, we will not take some height of the object or height of the image. We take it here that point object. So, O is a point object here. I is the point image. So, objects what we take are point objects. Similarly, the second assumption what we take is the angles that the incident ray, refracted ray, the normal that makes to the principal axis, as well as angle of incidence, angle of refraction, all these we will take it as very small. With the condition that is, you know that if angles are very small, if sines and tangents are, can be equated to that angle, sine theta is equal to theta, tan theta is equal to theta, if theta is very small. So we take that assumption also that the angles are, and we got five angles are marked, alpha, beta, gamma, I and R. So in the figure, you can make out that what are these angles. Angle I and R are angle of incidence, angle of refraction. Alpha, beta, gamma are, alpha is angle made by the incident ray is the normal. Beta is the normal, that means the principal axis. And the third one, refracted ray with the principal axis. So five angles you see here, I, R, alpha, beta, gamma. Assumption is that all these angles are very small. So that when you write tan alpha, it can be equated to alpha, tan beta, tan gamma can be equated to the respective angles. Similarly, you take sin A and sin R in the sense of application. So we can write sin A is equal to I, sin R is equal to R. Okay, so for that we take those assumptions. Now the next one is, what are the sign conventions, Cartesian sign conventions we take in this? That is, if the ray is, or the measurement is taken in the direction of the incident ray, it is taken as positive. In the opposite direction, it is taken as negative. So positive and negative, for the measurements parallel to the principal axis, how do we take it? Above and below also you have that. In this we are not using it. Above the principal axis is taken as positive. Below the principal axis is taken as negative. All the measurements are taken from the pole of the spherical surface. That is like what we say for the mirror, pole of the mirror. If you have one surface in, the midpoint we call it as the pole of the mirror. So all the measurements are taken. So in this, if you apply the sign convention, what will be the sign for you? We take it from M as origin, and incident ray is from left to right. So what will be the sign which should come for you? U is to be negative. So V and R, it is positive. So V and R are positive. In this, we get a relationship between U, V and R with the refractive index of the denser medium with respect to the rarer medium. So this equation in that way, which we use it in the derivation of Lenz formula and Lenz maker's formula. So for that, basis is this, because Lenz means you have two spherical surfaces in contact, two times the equation will be applied. So that is why here we are going to get a relationship between U, V and R with that of refractive index. So we take the right angle bracket. So I was putting a normal from N to the principal axis. You get a right angle bracket in which you can find out what is tan alpha, which can be equated to alpha. Similarly, from the normal, you can write what is tan beta, can be equated to beta. Similarly, tan gamma, which is equal to gamma. What do we write? We use the perspective right angle triangle. So what is tan alpha? Opposite side by adjacent side. So you will get this as equal to nm by om. Om approximately we take it as the object distance. Then next one for beta. What do you write for beta? The other right angle triangle mn CE affidavit, four times beta cubed, it will be equal to MM by MC. Where MC can be taken approximately equal to the radiation condition. Similarly, gamma, made the next with the refracted ray is the NM by. So, gamma opposite side is NM, so NM by MI. So, you can write these three alpha, beta, gamma. So, one is for getting what is it? Alpha, beta, gamma in the right hand of the triangles with respect to the incident ray, refracted ray and the normal. Next, we will have another relationship to get I in terms of this alpha and beta and R in terms of gamma and beta. You can write this relationship using just the property of the triangles. You can say what is for I as well as for R. Amen. I is equal to alpha plus beta. What is that? These two are the interior angle. I forms the exterior angle. Therefore, I exterior angle is the sum of these two interior angles. Similarly, you can write R as, what do you write? RC. What do you write for R? Right hand side. Here this triangle is the R, gamma, beta. You have. What will be R? Beta minus gamma, because beta forms the exterior angle with the sum of R and I, gamma. Therefore, R is the exterior angle beta minus the angle gamma. That is the refracted ray that makes the principal axis. Now, after this, we apply Snell's law. So, for this, applying Snell's law. What do you get in this Snell's law? Ujjwal, well, Lauti, what will be the Snell's law application here? In this refraction, refracted incident ray, refracted ray you have, angle I n, angle R you have. What will you get for applying Snell's law here? This case you have to apply, that is, here, you know that sin I is equal to I, sin R is equal to R. So what equation you will write here? Apply Snell's law. Sin I1 sin R is equal to N2 by N1. That is equation N2 by N1. That is N2 is the tensor medium. N1 is the refractive index of the tensor medium. N1 is the refractive index of the radar medium. So when you are writing it by taking sin I is equal to I, sin R is equal to R, you have the relationship from this as N1I is equal to NR. Because sin I is equal to I, sin R is equal to R. So when you are applying Snell's law, it becomes I by R is equal to N2 by N1. Therefore, N1I is equal to N2R. N1 must be cross multiplication. So N1I. Now in this, what we are going to apply? We apply that I is equal to R plus beta and R is equal to beta minus gamma. So by applying that, in this what is alpha, what is beta, what is gamma? In applying the equation, that is N1, what is I? I is alpha plus beta. This is equal to N2, it is R is right, R is equal to beta minus gamma. Just substituting the values of alpha, beta, gamma in the equation and simplifying it. N1 is equal to, for alpha it is Nm by Om. Just we have to substitute the values. Nm by Om plus beta is Nm by Mc is equal to N2 into beta is again Nm by Mc minus gamma is Nm by Mi. What is common in this? Nm is common in this and after that we have to just rearrange it. So that is in all the terms Nm gets cancelled. It is N1 by Om plus N1 by Mc is equal to N2 by Mc minus N2 by Mi. In this, you will see two similar terms. What are the two similar terms?
What you get that? MC, the radius of
curvature that comes. So that you can take to one side. So this is N1. So this can be taken to the other side. It is N1 by OM plus N2 by MI. This is equal to N2 minus N1 divided by MC. So next one is to apply the sign convention. And the sign convention? U is negative. What is U? U is OM or first one not able to be N1. So it becomes minus N1 by U plus MI is V. N2 by V is equal to N2 minus N1 divided by R. Okay. Here, required. You apply. So in three steps you are doing it. First we are writing alpha, beta, gamma. Then applying Snell's law by writing the relation between I and R in terms of alpha, beta, gamma. Third step, we simplify it by substituting I as alpha plus beta, R as beta minus gamma. The simplification is that to get the required result, right? N2 by V minus N1 by U is equal to N2 minus N1 by R. This is the relation between the refractive indices of the two media with a object distance, image distance and the radius of curvature. What is its use? I told you it is to be applied for deriving lens maker's formula and the lens formula. Thank you.